Thanksgiving is over, so some of you may be on the lookout for the perfect Christmas tree right about now.
Yeah, and it can be difficult. What exactly should you be on the lookout for? That yeah. is the big question. Our Brandon Roth is live at Paige's Christmas Tree Farm in Manlius to show us what's in store this season after the summer's drought.
Hello
Good
there.
Morning, Brandon.
Hello there.
Of course he would find an animal.
I got some friends here. That's Bambi. How great is this? This is here at Paige's Christmas Tree Farm. Oh, yes, good girl. Hey, I'll tell you what a great little gem Paige's Christmas Tree Farm is right here in Manlius off Orin Gulf Road. We have Cindy Page with us, and Cindy, we're talking this morning. It's that time of year to pick out the Christmas tree, and you've got plenty of them here. You can pick them out pre-cut, or you can go cut your own.
Right, right. We have a huge number, a great selection of wonderful trees.
Let's get right to people looking the two popular brands, the Fraser fir and the balsam fir.
Mm-hmm.
Let's look at the Fraser first. And what are the key points to look for if you're picking out a tree here?
This particular kind of tree has the best needle retention of any tree, any mm-hmm. Christmas tree at all. And of course, people like that. It's just a kind of balsam. It's been developed over the years. It's just a special kind of. It has stronger branches.
Get a shot, Craig. Pull in there and get in close on that. You can see. Yeah, people, you can really hold the ornaments up here. And as you said, these leaves, it holds the leaves longer.
Yes, very, very good. It has a little bluish cast underneath.
How soon after putting the tree, you want to get it in water right away? And you need to water the tree. People forget, right?
It doesn't count if you don't water
yeah.
it.
Well, people yeah. forget. They put
they
it in
do.
There.
They do. If they give it a fresh cut, and we'll do that yeah. for you here at the farm, then it starts drawing water yeah. up again.
And then we have over here, this is the balsam fir,
mm-hmm.
which is a variety of the Fraser, but a little bit different.
A little bit different. It has a wonderful fragrance. They both have
yeah,
the great
fragrance. People
fragrance,
love that.
But it's
yeah.
an old-time variety. People yeah. are pretty familiar.
Ooh, I love that. It smells like Christmas. It's exciting. And we should say there was concerns about the drought. And it mm-hmm. did, I know I did a couple of months ago, I went out to a farm, it did kill off a lot of the smaller trees.
Only the baby trees that uh-huh. we put in that year.
Yeah.
We lost some of those. But once trees have been put in the ground, they yeah. start developing a root system, and they're fine.
Okay,
they're
so fine. We were out, and we had some yeah. rain later on in yeah. the late summer, early fall. So that saved the trees, except for the baby ones. So that might be a problem down the road.
No. Oh. If they died, they died. You
right.
know, but many of them survived, and
right.
they'll be fine.
Okay,
yeah.
and if folks want to come down here, Paige's Christmas Tree Farm, yep. it's Orin Gulf Road,
yes.
and you're open?
We're open Tuesday through Sunday.
Okay, Tuesday through Sunday.
9 till dark.
9 till dark coming out. It's really a great place, guys, and you come on out and pick out the tree, and this just smells just like Christmas. I love it.
I like the wreaths behind you. Those are really pretty.
There.
Those wreaths are
yeah.
so pretty. I love
yeah.
those.
Oh, aren't these wreaths are beautiful?
Yeah.
And they have, she has all different kinds of decorations, too, besides the wreaths, too, for all throughout different parts of the house. So, yeah, you have to come on down and check it out. It's just a really cute place here, and they actually have a big owl, too, that the kids will love to see. So, and some other birds, wildlife here, too, as well.
Pretty
Great
cool.
place.
Thanks,
all right,
Brandon.
Thanks
yeah.
so much.
Okay.